Should you use the clutch to change gears on dual sport and adventure bikes? There's a lot of debate about this. As with many questions, there's no one right answer to suit everyone. Motorbikes use a different type of transmission to cars. It's a sequential gearbox. Technically, it does allow changing gears without a clutch. Many ask, why not simply use the clutch for all gear changes? Well, for some, it might be laziness. Others may find their left hand gets sore on longer rides, so clutchless gear changes reduce the pain, especially with a heavy clutch pull. If you're riding over very rough terrain, you might want to keep full grip on the bars and ignore the clutch. Others might like the challenge of getting that super fast but smooth gear change with no clutch. And finally, it can be good practice. If you ever lose your clutch, you can still keep riding and hopefully get home to fix it. The big question, of course, do clutchless gear changes wear out your gearbox faster? If done properly, the general consensus among motorbike mechanics is no. But if you often mess it up and you get that dreaded clunk, then you will be slowly wearing the dogs in your gearbox. And there's always the small chance of actual damage.
Our new Gumby Enduro boots don't just ram that lever, feel it, become one with the lever. At a cosmic level, you are the lever, and it is you.
Warning, will cause broken toes, snap tendons, crushed feet, and death through arterial bleeding. So, how do you avoid wear or potential damage? The key is no load on the gearbox when changing gear. So, when you shift to a higher gear, you back off the throttle temporarily, and there is a split second where there is zero load on the gearbox and a clutchless gear change is effortless. When changing down a gear, the key is to apply just enough throttle to remove any engine braking. Again, zero load on the gearbox. A few important caveats though. One, it is relatively easy to get this right when changing up gears, but it's much harder to get it right changing down. Personally, I have never bothered changing down gears without the clutch. Two, it's much easier to get it right on smaller capacity bikes like 250s and 400s. As you get into bigger capacity bikes, it typically gets harder to make that smooth gear change without any clunks. Three, it is hard to get it right in the lower gears because there is a big difference between the gear ratios. Many riders only start doing clutchless gear changes from third gear and higher for this reason. Or, are there any known issues with your gearbox? Potential failures, false neutrals, or is it simply a very clunky gearbox that doesn't lend itself to clutchless gear changes? A personal example, there's a small but persistent number of third gear failures on DR650s, so I only do clutchless gear changes up into fourth and fifth gears, never from second to third. 5. You do need a firm gear change, but without ramming it through. Being too light or too heavy can be equally bad for clutchless gear changes.
Is your heavy clutch causing an imbalance? See our 5 tips for a lighter clutch.
Of course, maybe you have just been single too long, in which case learn to use your other hand.
Okay, if you decide you do want to learn this, I recommend starting with the two highest gears, as the ratios aren't so wide and it's easier to get a smooth shift without the clutch. Also keep the revs reasonably low, there will be less chance of a clunk if you get it wrong. And again, remember, timing and speed are critical. Changing up gears, you only back off the throttle very briefly and make the change just as there is no power or engine brake occurring. If you really want to learn changing down gears, you need to apply just enough throttle to take all load off the gearbox and hopefully avoid the dreaded clunk or grind. If you are thinking of learning clutchless gear changes because of a very heavy clutch, remember there are also ways to lighten a clutch. See our video for at least 5 different methods. So, how many of you already do clutchless gear changes? Only up or down as well? Only the higher gears? and what sort of bike are you riding? Keen to hear everyone's experiences, there are so many different opinions on this topic.